So one of the first parts of the turban is to get the piece of cloth that wraps in at the back, at the very end. Now, the way that most Sikhs tend to do that is to take a small piece of the cloth and tuck it into their mouth, which will then, at the very end, at the culmination of tying the turban, wrap into the back to keep it all tight and solid at the back. The first, what we call lar, which is the first fold of the Sikh turban, that you can see comes from the back and goes from a high up position from around about what we'd say 11 o'clock, and it comes right down, right past the eyebrow and down past the lower end of the person's left ear. After the second or third fold has come across, what you notice with Gurbaj tying this now is that a point starts to emerge in the center of just above the person's forehead. That's what gives this particular style of turban what we call a nork. So it comes out and it gives it what was traditionally a style of turban that was worn by kings or rulers or emperors. So Maharajas would have worn this particular style of turban. The final fold is the one that, as I said, can save the turban, if you like. It's also the one that gives it its peak and gives it a sense of aggression, if you like, a masculinity that comes out. He then moves back to the part that was tucked into his mouth. And what he's doing is actually pulling that out, and that actually stretches out the fold that he had originally put over his head. And with the final part of the turban at the very back, he just pulls it out so that he's got all of it nice and neat and tidy. Brings it out. Make sure that it's neat and that there's no extra bits of the turban folding outwards. Instead, they fold inwards, and tucks it right into the back of the turban. And we're finished. Looks pretty good.